Paulo the Eraser Costa is an exciting powerhouse of a fighter that looks like he just stepped off the stage of a men's physique competition and decided he wanted to beat the shit out of people. Costa is a standout among the usual muscle-bound fighters, who gas out quickly and instead attacks his opponents with relentless pressure and aggression. With a 93% finish rate and 11 knockouts of his 13 fights, he doesn't mess around in the octagon. In this video, we will break down the stats and the science behind Paulo Costa and what makes him the fighter he is. The big standout when looking at Costa's fighting style is his aggressiveness and pressure. Costa holds the current UFC record for the most strikes landed per minute at a whopping 8.43 strikes per minute. For reference, Justin Gaethje comes in second at 7.74 strikes per minute, and Max Holloway only comes in 10th at 6.47 strikes per minute. What makes this especially crazy is that the record is held by someone as large and imposing as Costa, who looks like he could comfortably fight as a heavyweight. Costa has gone to the second round in every UFC fight except his fight with Romero, which went the distance, and he has shown that he can keep up his pressure without fading too significantly through three rounds. Whether he can keep that going over five rounds is still up in the air, but it's clear that he doesn't like letting his fights stretch out too long. Costa isn't just a meathead throwing wildly though, there's a method to his madness. He pressures his opponents to the cage and cuts off their routes of escape. When at this range, Costa likes to unload with powerful hooks and straights and blitzes to overwhelm his opponent. When circling, he tries to cut off his left side so his opponent is forced to circle to the right towards his right hand. He used this strategy for almost the entire three rounds against Romero. He particularly likes his lead hook and cross when his opponent has his back to the fence. Costa is 6'1", which is the same as the middleweight divisional average, but his 72-inch reach is 3 inches shorter than the 75-inch divisional average. Costa has very wide shoulders, meaning much of that 72 inches belong to his shoulder width and not arm length. This would mean Costa wouldn't do so well as a rangy fighter. This is another part of why he prefers up-close and personal dirty fights. Costa's pressure is what makes him a successful fighter, but it does come with a price. Costa has one of the highest strikes absorbed per minute stats in the UFC at 6.84 strikes per minute, and only has a significant strike defense of 53%, so he's taking almost as many shots as he's giving. His striking accuracy is 57%, so Costa's strategy is pretty clear. He likes to bully and brawl his opponents, and banks on them crumbling before he does, and most of them do. After all, no one else could walk down Romero for three rounds straight and leave the cage with his consciousness intact. Before Costa's fight with Romero, he had only ever reached the second round, which made many people question whether or not he would be able to maintain his pace if the fight happened to be dragged out. That fight showed us that he can keep that pressure and aggression up over three rounds without fading too much. The next thing we wanted to talk about is Costa's grappling, or more specifically, his lack of it. Costa is a jiu-jitsu black belt and a talented wrestler, but he doesn't utilize those skills offensively in the octagon. Instead, he utilizes his grappling skills to keep the fight standing as much as possible and defend takedowns. It also allows him to comfortably pressure strong wrestlers like Yoel Romero without having to hesitate too much over potential takedown attempts. At the time of this video, Costa has an 80% takedown defense stat and has attempted zero takedowns or submissions in the UFC, so it's pretty obvious that he likes it when things are kept standing. Paulo Costa is definitely a unique fighter. His blend of massive size and relentless pressure is a rare one and hasn't been seen often since before the USADA era. He is a fighter that guarantees excitement every time he steps into the octagon, and we look forward to seeing the rest of his career. Thank you for watching our video. If you enjoyed it, please like, comment, and subscribe for future videos.